In this episode of our design series, I'm going to show you how to create stunning fluid animation from start to finish. The technique I will demonstrate can be applied to any type of animation you want to create. For example, here is another animation I made using the same method. So let's dive in and get started with it. Now first of all, I would want to create her a frame 1920 by 1080. I would grab on the frame tool here and simply drag it here like so, just to create a basic canvas for our design. Just like that, now you can adjust the resolution to 1920 by 1080. I'm gonna fill the background of this frame with an image. So what I would do here is that click on this fill color and then switch this to the image. I can sweep the image in. I have this image of free pick and then simply use this here. Now what I'm gonna do here is try to adjust the exposure of it because it's way too intense. So I would just try to reduce this a little and then we reduce here the highlights a little. Now let's try designing the logo. Now I'm gonna use this color as a base blade. So let's start with it. Now I would grab again here the ellipse tool here and drag a basic shape here like so. And then I would go again to the fill here, and this time with this fill I would switch into the gradient. Now I want to fill this with a gradient of this magenta and cyanish color. So I would select the first slider here and select this and use the dropper tool here to fill this with the cyanish color. And then select the another one here. I can again grab the eyedropper and fill it with the magenta. Now I can adjust it further like so. Now this is fine. Now what I wanna do here is to create a rectangle here. I'm gonna grab the rectangle tool here and drag it here like so. Make sure the width is sent to that circular, which is about 92. So let's try to make this 92. Now if you click on the chain icon, it's gonna construct the proportion. So let's add this to 92. Now I can select the circle icon here from the layers panel. Let me adjust the scale for you so that you can see it properly. And then bring it to the front. Right click here and then bring it to front. Now let's try to fill this again with the same gradient, the different shades on the color palette. Now I'm gonna again switch to the gradient here and select this color like so. Again deselect this color and then switch it here. Now this is fine. We need to kind of give a bit of a radius here because right now it's too harsh. You can select the rectangle here and give a bit of a radius here like so. Now I can select the circle here, and when I hold Alt or Option, as you can see, I just kind of switch to the two cursor, which means now I can make a copy of it. If I hold Shift while holding Alt or Option, I can make a copy of it like so. Now we're gonna have to make a copy of this entire area of this two ellipse and rectangular when holding Shift or selecting multiple items like so. Now I can hold Alt or Option again and then drag it here. Now we need to fill this in the middle because right now it's just simply standing here. So what I would do here, again hold Alt or Option and then rotate this in 90 degrees by clicking on the rotation and then switch it here like so. I can adjust here the scale. Now if I want to put it below this, I can press the control or command the left bracket key and it will send it back. Or if you want, you can keep here the one side of the edge and the front on the right side, you can put it in the back like so. I would just leave it as it is. Now we need to somehow create here the L shape with the edge. So what I would do here, select this right side of the rectangle and then hold Alt or Option. Now rotate it again 90 by typing it here like so. Now I can adjust it here with precision. Now as you can see here, we are pretty much done here. Just want to make a copy of this circular and then add this one at the end of this L. So we have now H and the L. We can even increase it here as well. It's up to you, but I'm gonna just keep it as it is. Now we need to work on the texture. So what I would do here, grab the text tool here and type here hexa length. I'm gonna adjust this to black, rather extra bold, and then again back the fill and then adjust it here with the gradient again. Select this and select the another color of it with the magenta color. Now I can adjust it here until it looks aesthetically pleasing. Now let's try to animate it properly. Now first of all, what you need to do here is to group this. What I would do, I will hold Shift and select all of the items here like so. I'm holding my Shift to select multiple items and also along with the texture, and then right click here and then click on frame selection. Now as you can see here, we have a proper group. Now you can put it in the middle like so. Now you can animate it properly. Now this is really important, by the way, the frame grouping the elements. Now you can call this
frame animation. Now what you want to do here is that we can also call this completed logo. And now I'm gonna have to make a copy of this entire frame. Now if I hold alt option again, I can drag it here, another copy of here like so. Now we need to simply scatter the element inside. Make sure to never ungroup this, because otherwise this animation is not gonna work. And let me show you what I mean by that. So as you can see here, we have this completed logo and we have another completion. We can call this unanimated part. Now inside the element we have animation and we have another animation. They have both same name. Figma only works if the frame animation are same, otherwise it won't work. So make sure you don't ungroup it here like so. So let's try to play inside this. Let's try to adjust it within these elements. So what I would do here, drag this element like so, just trying to give the impression of animating it. We can put this above, we can put it here like so, we can put this one like so, just trying to scatter them so that we can create here the smooth animation effect. Now I'm gonna select the text here and I would move it to the left and just simply reduce the opacity of it. Now if you click on it, as you can see here, we are animation parted like that. This is our main group and most of the stuff are inside this. However, if while animating things are get outside, as you can see here, it is outside now. So what you would do are in the layer pane, select all of the elements like so by holding shift and select all of them and put inside the animation box. That way all the animated part would be inside the group. Now all you gotta do here is simply animate this. So what I would do here, go to the prototype mode and then click on the plus symbol and drag it here like so. Now make sure the animation is set to smart animate. I want to animate it for 1500 milliseconds and ease out is fine with me. Now as you can see here, our flow one is already edited here in the prototype. You can call it to whatever you want. I'm gonna just simply rename this to motion design. Now if I click on this and play it, as you can see it's not gonna work. I had to click on it. Now it's gonna create that animation. Now we need to create it using hover effect. Now if I again go back to the prototype which we connected here by dragging it from left to right, the trigger is set to unclick. We can set it to hover, click on while hovering. Now we are good to go. If I play it again the prototype and hover over it, as you can see here it's created. If I get my cursor out, it's gonna fade away. If I get it back, it's gonna complete the logo. Now, of course, you can adjust it here whatever you want. This is just to demonstrate it to you. So yeah, that's it for this video. I hope you guys like this short video of how to animate any SVG element within Figma. If you like this, be sure to give it a thumbs up. And also, if you like my overall content, I make videos, every single video is related to design and technology. If you would like to support this channel, smash that subscribe button with bell notification. Then I will see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.